I want to tell you about a bowl you may not have heard of. It's the diet bowl. Heard of it? No. Okay. It's a bowl that's played out every year. And they only have the same two contestants every year. And it's team fat and team carbs. They play off at the diet bowl every year. And as you know, for the last sort of a generation really, it's been the carb generation. And team carb has really dominated. It's been out there and everyone's been supporting team carb. And largely due, they've had two legendary coaches, team carb. They've had Gary Gatorade, he's been a sensational coach, and Paddy Powerade, he's also a great coach. And they're really two legends of the diet bowl. They've had enormous success. So I just want to show you some of the stats of the at least just this century anyway, the winners of the diet bowl since the year 2000. The winners each year, team carbs. It's pretty boring, really, isn't it? Pretty monotonous. And they've won pretty clearly, especially in that first decade of the century. And what about the MVP, the best player in the bowl game every year? Well, every year it was a guy called Tim Noakes. Now, you may have heard of him. He was a carb legend. Right back, way back from 1991, he'd been saying that there was clear evidence that the provision of exogenous carbohydrate at high rates was essential to delay fatigue. So Tim Noakes is a diet bowl legend. He's a carb superhero. He's a multiple MVP winner. He's written this book, The Law of Running, that's gone through numerous editions, and it's known as the Bible of Running. Anyone who's serious about running has read The Law of Running. And in that book, there's lots of good stuff about carbs. And then in 2012, breaking news.